Okay, here we are on another passage. There's Elizabeth reading her book. She's working hard. She's reading a book. We got our buddy boat over there, Imagine. As you can see, they're about a half a nautical mile off our starboard beam. We're just coming from the island of Carousel, which is over that way. I don't know if you can see it. We've got a big storm over there that we are trying to escape. And the sun will be setting soon. Very pretty sunset. The auto helm is doing what it does best. Going about 7.5 knots. Our wind's about 15. We're just kind of hanging out. We got a 5-day passage to the San Blas Islands and 5 days worth of books. We should be okay. What you making there?
I'm in the mood, okay?
I know you got your little hair thing on. I just want to see what you're making. Let's see what you're making. Oh, you're making a pizza. Ready to jive? Jive out!
No sooner like this than if you ask
that. That was terrible. That was a terrible job. Okay, it's February 17th, the first night of our passage, 5-day passage to Panama. We're doing well. We're just past the coast of Aruba, which you can see right there, and we're headed way out to sea, so we've got quite a ways to go here. You can see we left from Curacao, passing Aruba. This is our next waypoint, which we'll get to tomorrow, and we'll head south towards Colombia, and then arrive in Panama in about 5 days from now.
Look at that, wahoo! There you go. Not bad.
So here we are, the second night of our trip to Panama, and our wahoo tasted really good for dinner. But right now we're in a storm. It's about 2 a.m, and you can see we've got squall all around us. The wind's up over 20 knots, and we're picking up speed down these waves. We're going about 10 or 11 knots, and the whole boat is vibrating as we surf up onto the wave. And I'd rather not be doing that. So we're actually going too fast. 45 minutes later, and we're still in the middle of this big rainstorm. I just talked to our buddy boat, Mark, from Imagine. They're about 7 nautical miles southeast of us, and he's got the same thing on his radar, which is basically a ring of 6 nautical miles of rain, but in reality, it's actually much bigger just because the radar can't see past that rain. So both of us got this big ring of rain all around us, and hopefully it ends soon. We'll see what happens. You know the weather's rough when you have a bird land in your boat for refuge. So there's our little new pet. What's his name, Elizabeth?
Feathers.
Feathers. We have Feathers. And we just did another reef. We have 2 reefs in the main. Elizabeth did a great job pulling it in.
It's not fun.
It's pretty crazy out here. Okay, day 3. We've got 8 to 10 foot swells. We're surfing down the waves. We're going too fast, actually. We went about 15 knots down one wave, which is too fast for this boat, so we're doing everything we can to slow it down. And we're sticking close to our buddy boat, Imagine, which I'll show you in a minute. And we're wearing our life jackets, being safe, and just riding out this 36-hour storm. Here you can see our buddy boat Imagine behind this wave. They go up and down in the swells like we do. Sometimes they're visible, sometimes they're not. They're about a nautical mile away from us. They're running the same reef, 2 reefs in their main, and they're running no jump. Sticking together and riding out this rough part of the Colombian coast. It's actually notorious for being rough, so we knew what we were getting into, but it's always surprising when it goes from beautiful to rough. So I wrote about this in our blog, but here's a little taste of sailing life, passage making. We're filling beer bottles with salt water using a foot pump. It uses no electricity. Go outside. You can drop it into the water, which seems very strange, but it recycles it. It goes 6,300 feet in this case, and it's probably better than putting it in a landfill, really, I guess. Okay, it's night 3 of our passage, and right now we've got 40 knots of wind. We're basically hunkered down. We've got a tiny sliver of a Genoa up. basically just the UV shade. In essence, we're just running bare poles and we're going 10 knots at about 190 nautical miles today, which is a record for us. But here's our sail. As you can see, just a tiny sliver of sail. So it's dawn on day 4, surfing down these waves. Breaking, sometimes getting to 20 feet high, getting gusts of 50 knots. We're moving really fast. We've hit 18 knots a couple times, which has been scary. Buried the bow last night, lost our navigation lights. So we went to bare poles. We're not running any sail at all. We're just literally surfing down waves and using the wind to hit the boat, surfing with the mainsail bag. Got 20-foot waves. These waves. We're hitting about 18 knots. Coming down them, which is way too fast. Surfing down these waves. Trying to stay dry. Okay, go.
What am I doing?
You're telling everyone how we're doing.
Oh, hi. So this passage has been pretty bad, but now it's okay. We're almost there. Day 1 and day 2 were fine. Day 3 and day 4 were horrendous. We're now about finished. We've got 4 more hours, and we'll be off the coast of Panama in the San Blas Islands, which is supposedly very, very beautiful, and we're excited.
Very good. So how have you been sleeping?
Pretty good. I do most of the watches, which is hard, because I stay up all night, and why Seth sleeps, but other than that, it's been okay.
Uh-huh, uh-huh. Yeah, you look like you're on watch right now.
I'm on watch.
Watching.
Well, I watch the tutors, but then every 10 minutes I put it on pause and I go up and check the sails and look for boats, check the horizon. So I like to combine my hobbies.
Okay, very good. Let's do that real fast. We'll check the sails. Okay. 4 more hours. We're there.